I've recently downloaded an app on my phone called Pinterest. Yes, it's an older app and it's been around for a while, but I am pretty new to it, and I've been using it to get inspiration for builds lately, and I saw one that wasn't quite a barn, but kind of looked like a barn, that inspired me to build today's build. My name is Wintertooth100, and I got another tutorial for you. This is a pretty modular build. We're going to start with our oak logs, and we're going to pillar them up 4 blocks tall on all sides, except for the front and back. They will be 6 blocks tall, with the rest being 4 blocks tall. This is modular in that there are 4 potential entrances slash exits to this particular build, so you can squeeze it in into most places because we're only going to be choosing 2 sides to use for an entrance and an exit. Notice that the corner bits have a 2-block gap between them, while all of the center bits have a 3-block gap between them. We're going to continue with our oak, and we're going to put a cap on the ends of each of the beams, including the tall beams at the same height. With the tall beams indicating the front and back sides of the barn, we're going to come to the left and right side, and we will connect. We'll connect each of the pillars with a beam going across on both sides. Next, we'll grab the oak planks, and we will bridge the gaps on the front and back side in the corners like so. Then we will grab our brick, and we will fill in the empty areas in each of the corners along the bottom. At this point, you're going to want to select 2 of the 4 entrances to be functional. The rest will be sealed off. I'm going to seal off this one and this one. We'll grab the normal brick stairs and place them in upside down on either side of this full block to block them in completely. We'll finish up using the oak log. We'll connect the top beams of the 2 tall posts on either side and put a cap on either of them. This should complete us needing to use the oak for anything for the exterior. If you want to do the interior, you'll use a lot more oak. Next, we'll grab our spruce fence, and we will fill in each of these little window areas. We will come across the top of the center beam, and the same on this side. We will take our oak stairs and place them in upside down in the front, and then we will create a little gate situation right here. We will repeat this on the opposite side, except we will use fence to fill in this little bit. Remember to include your upside down stairs here. We will include the same gate on our second entrance, and we'll take our fence and we will continue to fill in all of the rest of the gaps all the way around the build. Next, we'll grab our buttons and our spruce stairs. We're going to put an upside down stair underneath each of the beams poking out, and then we will cap them all with a button. We will exclude this little gap here. We'll do something else with that in just a moment. But go around the whole build and place in your stairs and your buttons. On each of the entrances, we will also place an upside down stair, and between them, we will include a trap door. Be sure to do it on the front, even with these stairs there. At this point, you should have something that looks sort of similar to this. If you don't, please go back, check it again. It's pretty simple. Hopefully you'll be here at this point. Next, we're gonna grab our spruce slabs and we're gonna place them in on these positions on the front and back. Again, don't forget the back side. And then grab your spruce stairs and place one in upside down between both of them on the top. And then on either side, go ahead and put 1 spruce fence. Next, we'll grab our brick wall and we'll cap them on both sides of the building in the top between the 2 logs. And then for each of the entrances, we'll put them down here and place lanterns on top to help provide some light. So you'll do the same thing on the other entrance, place in the brick walls on the far side. And then to really cap off the last thing before we start the roof, we're gonna come to the center of this beam. We're gonna place in 4 spruce stairs just like that. And this is everything we're going to need before we start the final bit, the roof. With the build in this position, we just need to get the shape of the roof, and then the rest of it's just filling it in from there. So we're gonna start with a stair. We're gonna place it in right here between these 2 oak beams. We're gonna place in another stair, an upside down stair, a slab on top of that, a full block, a stair, upside down stair, a slab with a slab on top, and repeat the same thing on the other side. So again, we go stair, stair, upside down stair, slab, full block, stair, upside down stair, and it should meet up for your slab slab, and we will repeat this on the other side of the build. Continuing with the shape, we're going to grab our brick stairs and we're going to place them upside down in every space between the beams except for the center one. Instead of filling that in, we're going to grab our slabs and we're going to run our slabs all the way across, and we'll repeat this exact thing on the other side. So it'll be stair, 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 and then three slabs to cap it off. All right, pay attention. This is where things can get a little confusing. We're going to grab our spruce. We're going to be using only spruce from this point forward. We're going to place in a stair just like that and then connect it up to this side. We'll repeat the same for this side, and it'll be incredibly symmetrical. You're going to be doing the same thing over and over again. We're going to place another stair directly on top of that one and directly on top of this one. Then we can do our upside down stairs, and then we can do the same thing here. Slab, 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 and a slab on top, or you can make it a full block if you prefer. Try to keep things as simple as possible for yourself. Repeat it on the other side exactly like this. You should see that your fence connects up perfectly within that opening. Next, we're going to follow this exact pattern, and we're just going to bring it across. So we see we got a slab. We're going to bring our slab across, connect up the stair right here. Then we're going to grab our full block. We're going to bring that across. And then, of course, we have our stairs, which we bring across. We'll repeat this on this side. Now it should look something like this. Go ahead and grab your slabs and bring this across, and instead of connecting to the stair, we're going to place in a sideways stair so it connects like that with this little corner on both sides. Then grab your full block and just bring it across. You can go ahead and repeat this exactly on the other side. Now with both sides in, it's a simple matter of taking your spruce stairs, placing them in upside down all the way across, and then repeating it on the other side. With this complete, we'll grab our slabs, and it's up to you. You can either do a full block's worth, and they have to be slabs, or you can just do normal slabs all the way across. I personally like to do it this way, and then later I punch out the slab bits that are in the way for when I want to place in lanterns. Come to the very center, place in a little cross pattern, and just like that, your build is technically complete. You just have to do the interior now. So this is what the interior will look like when you first enter it with nothing on the inside. And there's lots of room for opportunities here. You'll just have to keep in mind where your two entrances are. Again, perfect piece for cornering on to a already existing city that you're working on, or a farm that you're already building, because the multiple entrances just allow for this to fit pretty much anywhere. And then for the ones with an actual interior in it, you can see what I've chose to do. I've added a few extra beams, so again, this is where you would use the extra oak if you are going to do something with the interior. Some people choose to just have it as for show with no interior. But we got our extra beams here. I've divided it across the second beam line, created three individual pens, created a little blacksmithing area, maybe for horseshoes or something. You can see we've used the beams to create a division here, to create a staircase going up. And this is why it's important not to do upside down stairs or anything like that, because you will bump your head and you will have to break out those blocks if you place in secondary blocks under everything, which is something that we purposefully skipped doing during the build. You see, we've got plenty of room for storage. You keep your armor up here, you got a bed, you got extra storage, you got your carpet, you got, of course, this is technically a barn and a temporary living quarters, so you got hay, you even got a little view down to the animals. That's mostly practical for when you are riding a horse and you want to dismount. You won't bash your head into anything and take suffocation damage. And then of course the floor is just all decorated. So this is my very small, hopefully it's a perfect little build for the place that you need it for, little barn slash starter home. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed, please let me know in the comments down below. Leave a like if you liked, subscribe if you haven't. I know most of you aren't subscribed. I can see my analytics. Something like 92% of people watching my videos are not subscribed. Why aren't you subscribed? Subscribe. And that will be everything. My name is Wintertooth100. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.